I found out just within like the last 10 or 15 years that there's always been people like me. I remember exactly the day it was too. I was in a museum. I think it was a Museum of the American Indians on 155th in Amsterdam. And I saw this whole case of these little sort of thumb-sized pottery men and women. And it was perfect, you know, all the women had little clay breasts and little tattoos and stuff. And then there were sort of little figures with different kind of tattoos and bows. Now, this sounds very simplistic about the basket and the bow, and I really don't mean it very simply at all. But so I was looking at them, and I noticed that a couple of the little clay women didn't have breasts, and a couple of the little clay men did. And I couldn't figure it out. And I kept standing there staring at that case for a long time, thinking about it. And finally I called the curator of the museum. And he actually asked me, why do you want to know? Why do you want to know? Like the information can only be given out on a need to know basis, you know? So I said, well, I'm a student at Columbia. Because I wanted the information, and I was afraid it would become inaccessible to me if I said, because I'm one of those little clay dolls without breasts, you know, with a bow, what can I tell you? So he said, well, yes, it's quite amazing, isn't it, about the burdash. I had never really thought about the word before, and he said, I come across it every day in my reading. His own tone got kind of scared, you know. He sort of dropped down. He dropped his face and he said, it's really very disturbing, isn't it? And I was just so mad. I was so mad. And that's how I felt when I found out about Joan of Arc. What if I had known all that when I was growing up, you know? I mean, what kind of possibilities that would have opened up for me to find my place in the world, to find my place in history. There's a reason why I didn't know all that stuff. It's not just that they didn't tell me, they didn't want me to know it, and I needed to know it, but I found it anyway.
There's an old African saying that until the lions come to power, the hunters will write the history. You know? So this is the lions taking back their own history.